All praise is due to Allah alone. We praise Him, thank Him, seek His guidance and His forgiveness. We repent to Him. We seek refuge in Allah from the evil of our souls and our sinful deeds. Whoever Allah guides, none can mislead. And whoever Allah misleads, none can guide. Every time I try to speak about the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, our role model, may Allah's peace and blessings be upon him, I see that there is an ocean before me. An ocean with no end. No matter how I try to reach with the other end, I will not be able to reach with the other end. No matter how good of a swimmer I might be, I won't be able to reach with the other end. Why? Because simply there is no other end. Every great person in the history of mankind was great because he possessed one, two, or few good qualities. But the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, may Allah's peace and blessings be upon him, reached the peak of excellence of all good qualities that a human being can possess. May Allah's peace and blessings be upon him. This great Prophet, if you want to know his status in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, just reflect upon the Quran. See how Allah ta'ala addresses him. Allah Ta'ala addresses every and each prophet by their names. Ya Musa, aqbil wa la takhaf. O Musa, come and don't be scared. Falamma ataha nudiya ya Musa. And once he arrived there, he was called by his name, O Musa. Ya Ibrahim, a'rid an hadha. O Ibrahim, forsake this matter. Ya Isa, inni mutawaffika wa rafi'uka ilay. O Isa, I'll be taking you and ascending you to the heaven. Allah Ta'ala addresses and called every prophet by their names. But when it comes to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, go throughout the whole Quran, you'll find him, Allah Ta'ala always addressing him by his title. The prophethood title. The messengerhood title. Ya ayyuha ar-rasul balligh ma unzila ilayka min rabbik. O the messenger, convey that which has been revealed to you from your Lord. Ya ayyuha ar-rasul la yahzunka alladhina yusari'una fil kufr. O the messenger, don't be grieved with those who vie each other in the disbelief. Just to know his status in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took an oath from all the prophets in the unseen world, before we were all created, that if I send Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to all of you, or to any of you, or the prophets, you will believe in him. And you will support him. And you will follow him. And all the prophets said, O Allah, we acknowledge, we will follow him, we will support him. وَإِذْ أَخَذَ اللَّهُ مِيثَاقَ النَّبِيِّينَ. When Allah Ta'ala took the oath from all the covenants, when Allah Ta'ala took the covenant and the pact from all the prophets. لَمَا آتَيْتُكُم مِّن كِتَابٍ وَحِكْمَةٍ. By the wisdom and the scripture and the knowledge that I have given you. ثُمَّ جَاءَكُمْ رَسُولٌ مُصَدِّقٌ لِمَا مَعَكُمْ. Then a messenger, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, came to you confirming what you have, what you possess. لَتُؤْمِنُنَّ بِهِ وَلَتَنْصُرُنَّ. You shall believe in him and you shall follow him and support him. قَالَ أَقْرَرْتُمْ وَأَخَذْتُمْ عَلَى ذَلِكُمْ إِصْرِي. Allah Ta'ala asked them, are you taking up my covenant? Do you agree? They all said, oh Allah, we agree. Oh Allah, we acknowledge. Oh Allah, we'll take up your covenant. If Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was sent in our time, we will follow him, we'll believe in him, and we'll support him. I, Ibrahim, if Muhammad was sent in my time, I will believe in him, and I will support him, and I will follow him. I, Musa, likewise. I, Isa, likewise. And all said the same. Just to know the status of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the sight of Allah, our Creator. This great being, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, loves you. He loves you, and he was keen to see you. In one occasion, he went to the cemetery. In his last days in this life, he went to the cemetery and he was very grieved, very sad, And he spoke to his companions saying that, I wish that I can see my brothers. I said to him, O Messenger of Allah, we are your brothers. Aren't we your brothers? He said, no, you are my companions. But my brothers are those who will come after me and believe in me without seeing me. May Allah make us from them. Say Ameen. They said to him, Messenger of Allah, how would you be able to recognize them in the hereafter? He said, if one of you has in his farm, has white-footed horses with white foreheads amongst black or pure black horses, will he be able to know them? Will he be able to know his own horses? He said, of course, Rasulullah, he'll be able to know them, different colors. He said, they will come in the day of judgment and their limbs will beam in brightness from the trace of the wudu. Because they used to pray, they used to perform wudu and ablution, and that's why their limbs will come in the day of judgment beaming in brightness. And I will be able to recognize them and know them. I will call them to come to my home. I will be the first one to arrive to the Hawd al-Kawthar. May Allah Ta'ala grant us to be among those people. Ameen. This great being, Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, wept and shed tears out of fear for you. When he recited the verse in which Allah Ta'ala said about Isa alayhi salam, إِن تُعَذِّبُهُمْ فَإِنَّهُمْ عِبَادُكَ. Isa will say about his people, oh Allah Ta'ala, if you finish them, they are your servants. وَإِن تَغْفِرْ لَهُمْ فَإِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْعَزِيزُ الْحَكِيمُ. And if you forgive them, you are the Almighty, the All-Wise. And then again, he recited the verse in which Ibrahim alayhi salam spoke about his people, saying to Allah Ta'ala, apologizing to him about the mistakes of his people, saying, رَبِّ إِنَّهُنَّ أَضْلَلْنَا كَثِيرًا مِّنَ النَّاسِ. Oh Allah, these idols have led many people astray. فَمَن تَبِعَنِي فَإِنَّهُ مِنِّي. Whoever followed me from my people, he's of me. Treat him as you treat me. وَمَنْ عَصَانِي فَإِنَّكَ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. And whoever disobeyed me and went astray, oh Allah, you are the most forgiving. Oh Allah, you are the most merciful. Look at their mercy. How they used to be merciful towards their people. When the Prophet read these verses, he started crying, weeping, and shed tears. Then Allah Ta'ala sent Jibreel alayhi salam to ask him why. He replied, my nation and my nation. Allah Ta'ala replied to him, sending Jibreel alayhi salam to tell him that Allah Ta'ala will make you pleased in regard of your nation. I will not disappoint you in that regard. Subhanallah. Every prophet, Allah Ta'ala granted him a supplication that will be answered in this life. And every and each prophet made his supplication in this life. Apart from whom? Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Sulaiman alayhi salam made his supplication and his dua. He said, oh Allah Ta'ala, give me a kingship that no one will be given in this life, in this world, before me or after me. Allah Ta'ala granted him this.
قَالَ رَبِّ اغْفِرْ لِي وَهَبْ لِي مُلْكًا لَا يَنْبَغِي لِأَحَدٍ مِّن بَعْدِي.
Oh Allah, forgive me and give me a kingship that no one should be given after me.
إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْوَهَّابُ.
You are the all-giving, oh Allah. Allah Ta'ala granted him this. Zakariya alayhi salam asked Allah Ta'ala to give him offspring, to give him children. Allah Ta'ala replied to him, and each prophet made his dua in this life. But him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, said that every prophet has an accepted dua, and every one of them made his dua, and I delayed, postponed my dua to the hereafter to make it as an intercession for my nation. Because he loves me, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Do you love him? Do you want to meet him on the hawd? If you love him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and you want to meet him, you'll have to follow him. You'll have to be like him. You'll have to follow his guidance. You'll have to see how he used to treat people and treat them likewise. You'll have to see his manners, his attitudes. You'll have to reflect the best image of Islam like he used to do, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Look at him, Allah Ta'ala summarizing his message, summarizing his mission, saying that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was sent as a mercy to all of humanity. Thus, is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ O Muhammad, we have not sent you except as a mercy to all of humanity. And everyone who follows Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he has to be likewise. A mercy to all of humanity. قُلْ هَذِهِ سَبِيلِي This is my way. أَدْعُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ عَلَى بَصِيرًا I call towards Allah upon sure knowledge. أَنَا وَمَنِ اتَّبَعَنِي I do that myself and everyone who truly followed me. أَنَا وَمَنِ اتَّبَعَنِي وَسُبْحَانَ اللَّهِ And glory be to Allah. وَمَا أَنَا مِنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ And I'm not from those who associate in their worship in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. With Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So those who truly follow Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they'll have to take him as a role model and they'll have to do what he used to do sallallahu alaihi wasallam in all of his affairs. He sallallahu alaihi wasallam showed us and told us that as a Muslim, you will have to reflect the best image of your religion, of your deen. You cannot say I'm a Muslim and a believer in Islam and then you act otherwise, you cheat, you lie. And you show aggression towards people. The Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, if we reflect upon his biography, just see how he used to be Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam merciful towards his people. Aisha radiallahu anha said that he used to be at the service of his family. While he's at home, he used to serve us. One of the companions in one of the battles, when one of the prisoners was an articulate person who used to attack the Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam in every occasion, in every time. He attacks him because he was very articulate. And then when he became a prisoner, one of the companions said to the Messenger of Allah, let's pull out his lower teeth so that he cannot speak in the future properly. The Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam replied immediately saying, how can I do this? If I do this, Allah Ta'ala will disfigure me. Although I'm his prophet, although I am his messenger, Allah Ta'ala will punish me in this life. The Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam told us that Allah Ta'ala threw a person or a woman in the hellfire because she placed a cat inside the cage until she passed away out of hunger. And he told us Allah Ta'ala gave forgiveness to a person or to a woman who just gave water to a thirsty dog. Subhanallah. And Allah Ta'ala allowed it to enter Jannah. It's to show us how this message, the message of Islam, is a mercy to all humanity, even to the animals. And when you see people now reflecting another wrong or an image that has nothing to do with Islam. An image that shows another religion, an image that doesn't care about Islam at all, an image that does not care about Muslims at all. And then they do that in the name of Islam. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam never took retaliation for himself, never. And then with people saying that, in the name of Islam, we'll take retaliation. We have to, if you want to meet the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and you want to meet him on the Hawl and be with those people who will be invited towards him, we'll have to follow his footsteps. We'll have to be like him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in every affair, every matter. What we should care about is to call people to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to direct people to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to show people the right path. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in many occasions, if you go through the whole Quran and the whole authentic Sunnah, You won't see him that he's allowing a person to kill any innocent person. This, with disregard of his belief. You won't find any evidence saying that kill an innocent person. And if anyone comes with anything, with any idea that is against the Quran or Sunnah, we'll have to reject it. You won't find that in the Quran. So from where? It comes from their own retaliation. Their own anger. their own thinking, and then they claim it to be Islam. It's not Islam. Islam is a mercy to mankind. Islam is a guidance to mankind. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala own all of this universe. Allah ta'ala in one command can make everybody Muslim. And everybody submitting. And everyone in this universe submits to Allah ta'ala. Everyone, except the fool ones from the mankind and the jinn kind. But everyone glorifies Allah ta'ala, submits to Allah ta'ala. But we are here in this world for Allah ta'ala to try us, to see how we behave. Allah ta'ala in the Quran said, and I will finish with this, تسبح له السماوات السبع والأرض ومن فيهن. The seven heavens and the earth and everything on them, they glorify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They submit to Allah. They worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ولكن لا تفقهون تسبيحهم. But you cannot understand their glorification. Their praise to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Their submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إنه كان حليما غفورا. He was the ever clement and the oft forgiven, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So everything belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We as worshippers of Allah ta'ala will have to follow the guidance of Allah, which we receive through His Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We understand that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most powerful. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the Almighty. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can turn everything in a glance of in a matter of a second, and can change everything in a matter of a second. We understand that, we believe in that. But what we have to do in this life, we will have to follow the guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we have received from Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allahumma a'izz al-Islam wa al-Muslimin, wa adhill al-shirka wa al-mushrikeen. Allahumma ya Rabbi al-alamin, aslih lana dinana, alladhi huwa ismatu amrina, wa aslih lana dunyana, alati fiha ma'ashuna. وأصلح لنا آخرتنا التي إليها معادنا واجعل الحياة زيادة لنا في كل خير واجعل الموت راحة لنا من كل شر اللهم يا رب العالمين اللهم نسألك حبك وحب من يحبك وحب كل عمل يقربنا إلى حبك اللهم اجمعنا بنبيك صلى الله عليه وسلم اجمعنا على حوضه صلى الله عليه وسلم اجعلنا من أتباعه الصادقين يا رب العالمين اللهم نسألك أن ترزقنا اتباعه صلوات الله وسلامه عليه على الوجه الذي يرضيك عنا يا رب العالمين إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون فاذكروا الله العظيم الجليل يذكركم واشكروه على نعمه يزدكم ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون.